Everybody, welcome to PC Perspective. I'm Ryan Schrout, joined by Alan Malventano. We're here to talk to you about the launch of a new family of SSDs from Samsung. Mm-hmm. In this case, the 850 EVO, which is successor, I guess, to the 840 EVO.
Right.
In the same family, I guess we'll call it, as the 850 Pro.
Yeah.
It's got the same model number at the beginning, right? So it's got to be somewhat similar.
Well, it's got the same flash.
Okay. Is that the defining factor of an 850, I guess, at this point? Either way?
Yeah. Basically, the 850 series is the 32-layer VNAND.
Okay.
Right.
So what is different about the EVO versus mm-hmm. the Pro model? That's kind of the most important question, I guess, to start off with.
So the Pro had MLC flash. That would be 2-bit per cell MLC.
Okay.
So whereas you used to have SLC flash that was really, really fast, then economies of scale and, like, you know, you just kind of like need more efficient use of that space mm-hmm. on the die. And you can pretty reliably store 2 bits per cell. So that's just pretty much what most things have been doing lately.
Okay.
Right? So that's the Pro. Then there's the EVO, which is a transition to triple level cell, or if you want to call it 3-bit MLC, some people call it that too.
840 EVO had TLC memory as well.
It did as well, but it was on 2D NAND. It was on flat NAND.
Gotcha. Okay.
Right, not 3D.
Okay.
So we saw a bunch of speed advantages back for the whole 850 Pro thing.
Right.
Right. Due to the 3D NAND and the change in die capacity and all that stuff.
Right. How much that carries over to these products?
It's not. It's kind of a give or take kind of a thing, because you're going back to triple level cell, right? These 850 EVOs are all faster than the 840 EVOs.
Okay, that's a good start.
That's just get that out of the way, obviously.
All right.
They've made some controller tweaks. There's things that I've seen in the benches that are different that would indicate to me that the controller is just more optimized firmware.
One example sort of being?
Iometer, probably.
Okay.
The cache seems to last a little longer. We have a specific kind of a sequence that we do on Iometer, and it was actually a convenience that the sequence eats into the cache at a certain rate for an EVO, and then as it's going through the sequence, all of a sudden you'll see a dip in performance.
Gotcha.
As you go through, and these can get further
before that
into that
occurs.
Sequence before the dip occurs, given, okay. And it's doing the same exact workload.
Now, do they tell us how much cache is on these, or is it kind of a, we have to guess based on performance results?
They didn't put actual numbers in the press kit for us this time, but mm-hmm. just going off of the 840 EVO, which is, well, it seems to be pretty darn close as far as how they respond, just from doing like stopwatch testing of sequential writes and whatnot.
Right.
Seems pretty much the same. So you end up with 3 gig of an SLC cache at the low end.
On the 120 gig.
On the 120 gig. Yep. And I believe the 250, although we didn't have that sample to test, but that should also be 3 gig. And then the 500 gig gets 6 gig, and then there is not a 750 this time.
No 750. Do they jump straight to 1 terabyte?
They jump straight to 1 terabyte.
All right.
And that will have a 12 gig cache going off of.
In theory.
You know, in theory. Yeah.
Gotcha.
They probably stuck to the same kind of formula. It seems to be in what we've seen in the testing.
Is the controller on this the same as the Pro?
Okay, so that's where it gets a little weird. Where it used to be, the 840 EVOs had this, I believe it was the MEX controller, mm-hmm. right? They kind of shared the same controller over EVO and Pro, and they were basically the same kind of thing, just talking to different kinds of flash,
yep.
right? This is different, a different story this time. I need to make sure I got my model number right on the controller.
Don't screw that up.
Yeah, because MEX is still a thing. But it's only in the 1 terabyte 850 EVO.
Okay.
Okay. Now, the MEX was a triple core ARM controller.
All right.
All right. Samsung figured out that they could get good enough performance out of a dual core controller, so they came up with a MGX.
For the lower capacities, 500, 250, 120.
Correct.
Gotcha.
And from what we've seen in testing, I don't really see any kind of a performance dip. If anything, you know, it's that these are still performing much better than the 840 EVOs, respectively.
So let's talk about performance then. What kind of benchmark results do we see here? How much slower is it than Pro? How much faster is it than the 840 EVO, I guess?
Okay, so compared with 840 EVO, just kind of across the board, you would see like a 15 to 20% gain.
Okay.
In just about everything.
Sequentials,
random access.
Okay, that's good.
That's kind of just a rule of thumb thing I would say to use. And that's based on, we've only tested the 120 and the 500, but
right.
pretty safe to say it's going to carry over to the other two capacities as well.
Okay.
That's kind of just the the catch-all there. There's other gains where you might see even more performance boost versus an 840 EVO, like what you get from the shift to 3D NAND, right? In other words, the raw sequential speeds gets a bit of a boost. The cached speeds, actually, VNAND running in SLC mode seems to be pretty darn quick.
Which would be the cache, okay, yeah.
Which would be the cache, right?
Right.
Especially in the 500 gig model, which has more dies worth of parallel SLC, mm-hmm. when you're talking about just writing to the cache, because each die has a little chunk of that SLC cache on it.
Interesting,
right?
Okay.
So in our, if you look at our file server testing in Iometer, it's actually pretty wild because the file server, it does, you know, random reads, but mixed with random writes. Usually the random writes are the limiting factor because the flash takes longer to write than it does to read. Mm-hmm. The 850 EVO 500 gig model beat everything else that we put in the comparison, including the 850 Pro.
That does not have a cache.
That does not have a SLC.
Does not have SLC.
Right.
Right.
So
it's all MLC.
It's all MLC.
Gotcha.
Right. So when the 850 EVO was running in TLC slash SLC, right? SLC for the fresh reads, mm-hmm. TLC for, or sorry, for the fresh writes, TLC for the reads.
Okay.
Right. It's the highest thing in the test, right? So depending on what you hit it with, you might actually want to use an 850 EVO versus an 850 Pro.
Do you consider, like, do we know, I guess also, do we know the pricing on these yet? Do we know where they kind of fall in cost per gig? Because, right, the E40 Pro has always been a fantastic performing SSD, but it's always been more expensive, right? And the 850 Pro is, again, a fantastically high performance SSD that you really love, but its pricing has always been high. The EVOs are always less expensive. How
right.
much less expensive do we see these at this time?
So if you go all the way up to the 1 terabyte model, and this is your only launch prices we have to go on.
Sure.
And historically, EVOs have always dropped after launch
okay.
in price, right? But launch prices, 1 terabyte and even $500.
Okay.
So 50 cents
starting
a gig.
Starting out 50 cents a gig.
Right.
Okay.
Of course, it ratchets up after that, right? You go down to 500 gig, 270. So it's a little bit higher than 50 cents a gig. 250 gig model is 150, and then the 120 gig model is 100.
Okay.
So you start getting down to the point where you're paying for the controller
right.
and the packaging and stuff like that at the really low capacity.
So what is your opinion of these drives after having used them for, I don't know, a week or so now, in terms of, is this the new drive you recommend for not top of the line stuff, like not close to dollar per gig, 80 cents per gig? Component selection?
Honestly, for me, if I was putting drives on my system, just personally, mm-hmm. I would probably go with one or maybe even a RAID of a pair of these 850 EVOs.
Okay.
Because of the SLC cache. Because I, even as crazy as I am with storage stuff, I don't typically write gigabytes worth of data to my main drive.
Right. At one time.
At one time.
Yeah. Yeah,
and,
yeah.
And even if I did, even if it was a bulk file copy from something else, chances are the something else is slower than the TLC write speeds of these drives, right?
Okay.
Because just an example, the smallest capacity, we were talking about like smallest capacity of, say, a Micron M550
yep.
or other drives, right? The TLC write speed of these actually matches those slower speeds we were talking about on those other drives. So that 120 gig model, the saturated write speed is 150 meg per second at TLC
right.
speed.
Right, after you've gone through the SLC cache.
After you've gone through the SLC cache. But the SLC cache on that is pretty much saturating the bus.
SATA.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you have 3 gig of it, right? And if you took, say you found a good deal on a couple of 120 gigs of those, that gives you a total of 6 gig worth of that SLC cache if you're doing a RAID
okay.
0, right?
Okay.
It's effectively just scales up. So yeah, I mean, what are the chances of you writing, you know, more than 300 meg per second rate for more than
right.
6 gig worth of data? You're just not going to have that anywhere else in your system to get it that fast.
So the question has to be asked then, with the issues that cropped up with the 840 EVO,
right?
Have they mentioned this? Has Samsung said, hey, you know, trust us, the 850 EVO is not going to have that issue. We've addressed it. Is there some technological difference why it would?
They haven't specifically come out and said, hey, that issue will not happen with this, but I think it's just implied at this point because it was an issue with the 840.
Right.
They fixed it. we're pretty sure that this launch was delayed due to that, I would imagine.
Okay.
Just from all the kind of things we've seen around, you know, we saw rumors of the 850 EVOs
some
for a while
and,
back
yeah.
and leaks and stuff,
yeah.
and it's still taking it a while after those leaks to come to market. So my guess is initially they wanted to be able to beat the whole Christmas rush and Thanksgiving and Black
right.
Friday and stuff with these drives, but then that whole thing happened a few months back and they did a little reset and pause and fix all of our stuff before we move forward. So
I'll be very curious to see kind of how pricing settles out on these as they launch, if those prices that they gave you for MSRP at launch are going to be where they sit at for a little while, because I think even with some of the issue, you know, some of the branding issues they'll have with the EVO brand going forward because of the issues with the 840 EVO,
right.
these drives look pretty impressive. Now, if you guys want to see the rest of Alan's benchmarks, and there's a whole lot of other testing in there. You did RAID testing.
We did RAID testing. We actually forewent getting a full capacity roundup or trying to push for that, and instead we had so much feedback on people running 840 EVOs in a pair of RAID,
mm-hmm.
right? Back when there was that issue with the firmware.
Mm-hmm.
I had more people asking me, hey, how do I update these in a RAID than just, hey, how do I update these?
Right.
Right? It seems that a lot of people run these in RAIDs. So I asked for a pair of 120s, and we did RAID testing on that. And then I also am using the updated Samsung Magician software, and we're going to test the 120 and the 500 in rapid mode and just run it through the whole suite and just see what it looks like with that, you know, RAM, dynamic RAM caching.
Yeah
just figured I would just test the heck out of these things because, you know,
doesn't allow for an apples to apples comparison to other drives, but
not really.
Interesting nonetheless.
So. Yeah, some people have asked for it in the past and with the 840 EVO piece, so we figured, well, what the heck, we'll just throw every possible test we can in this one.
So go to PCPro.com. He's got that review up there when you're seeing this video. So you'll see the RAID testing, the rapid testing, in addition to the 120 and 500 gig regular benchmarks of the 850 EVO. For now, we'll leave you with that. We'll see you next time, guys. Thanks.